Let's learn about the sinuses. The sinuses are important anatomic structures. Sinusitis is one of the 10 most common primary care diagnoses, and sinusitis accounts for over 10% of all antibiotic prescriptions. Sinus problems are extremely common, yet it is an anatomic region that is poorly understood by many. The paired maxillary sinuses are the most known and largest of the sinuses. They are on each side of the nasal airway, above the teeth, and below the eyes. The maxillary sinuses are shown in red. The frontal sinuses are behind the forehead and over the eyes and are shown in green. Between the eyes are a honeycomb of small sinuses called the ethmoid sinuses. They are shown in blue. Farthest back are the relatively large sphenoid sinuses, shown in yellow. Sinuses are simply air spaces in bone that form during development and expand into early adulthood. They are like small caves inside several of the bones of the skull. The airspace over your forehead in the frontal bone is called the frontal sinus. The airspace over your teeth is called the maxillary sinus. The human skull is composed of 22 different bones. The junction between adjacent bones is called a suture, and it forms solid unions in adults. Let's walk into the sphenoid sinus to consider the cave comparison. If you could walk into the opening of the sphenoid sinus standing upright, the ceiling of the cave would be roughly 50 feet high. Some sinus problems are related to the shape of the sinuses and to the unavoidable issues that can develop when you have a large space that must drain through a small opening. Healthy sinuses continually make mucus, and that must drain out of the sinus opening. Each sinus is named after the specific skull bone that contains it. The maxillary sinuses are within the paired maxillary bones, shown in red. The frontal sinuses are within the frontal bone, in green. The ethmoid bone is shown in blue. The ethmoid sinuses are that part of the ethmoid bone that is like a honeycomb of small air cells. They are the most complicated group of sinuses and occupy that critical space between the eyes and just below the brain. When viewed in this sagittal plane, you can see how the ethmoid sinuses occupy the upper parts of the nasal cavity from the front to the back. The sphenoid is seen in yellow and is behind the nasal passage. The ethmoid sinuses, shown in blue, are further divided into the anterior ethmoid sinuses and the posterior ethmoid sinuses. The posterior ethmoid sinuses are shown in purple. These two subdivisions of the ethmoid sinuses have distinct drainage pathways. Anatomic dissections provide another perspective on sinus anatomy. Here we see the left half of the specimen viewed from 90 degrees. The sphenoid sinus and the frontal sinus are seen near the midline. The middle turbinate is a component of the ethmoid bone and forms the medial wall of the anterior ethmoid sinuses. The superior turbinate is also part of the ethmoid bone and forms the medial wall of the posterior ethmoid sinuses. If we remove the middle and superior turbinates, we can see the anterior and posterior ethmoid sinuses. The inferior turbinate is a distinct bone and is not a part of the maxillary bone to which it is joined. It runs from the front of the nasal airway to the back. Removing the inferior turbinate and the medial portion of the maxillary bone reveals the airspace of the maxillary sinus. The same structures as viewed from 45 degrees. The sphenoid sinus, the frontal sinus, the middle turbinate, the superior turbinate. After the middle turbinate and superior turbinate are removed, the anterior ethmoid sinuses and the posterior ethmoid sinuses can be seen. After the inferior turbinate is removed and the medial portion of the maxillary sinus wall, the airspace of the maxillary sinus can be seen. CT scans and other x-rays complement the physical exam when evaluating patients with sinus and nasal problems. The most common type of x-ray used is the coronal CT scan. Let's look at three CT scan slices and the basics of sinus radiology. The anterior slice shows the frontal sinus and the incisors. The middle slice includes the maxillary sinus, the ethmoid sinuses, the nasal septum, and the relationship of these structures to the dentition, brain, and orbital contents. The posterior slice includes the sphenoid sinus and its relationship to the brain and orbital apex.